Monrovia.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings we bring to you and your kin. Good tidings for Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Hi, everybody. My name's Jalen.
And my name's James.
And we're the K Band. We're going to do a couple songs for you to try and, you know, brighten up the season. So let's do it.
Have yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be far away. Here we are in olden days, in happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together. And if the fates allow, hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Christmas 2020. Amazing, and it's not exactly here yet. We have so much really to be thankful for. You might be wondering, what are you talking about? If you're still alive and you can breathe and you're walking around, you are truly blessed in more ways than one, because so many other people have passed away. So this Christmas, you really should take the time to look at someone in the eye and tell them that you love them. Not in an artificial way, but with some compassion and some understanding. It was a turbulent summer, and I'm so proud of young people that went out there the first time to vote. It changed the whole trajectory of what was going on in the world, and shouting out Black Lives Matter. That's still important as I speak right now. So you have yourself a wonderful Christmas out there. And all those folks that wish me a happy birthday in the month of November, a special salute to you. I really appreciate that in more ways than one. Now, someone asked me, what is the Walker tradition? What do you do every Christmas? Well, our tradition starts on Thanksgiving Day, right after everyone has stuffed themselves with food in so many different ways. I was to my audience, I was talking about the menu and all what was there, from macaroni and cheese to turkey to sweet potatoes to sweet potato pie to cakes to homemade cranberry sauce and a host of other great victuals that you love to eat until you can eat no more. And then we stop, and I might throw a couple of logs in the fireplace to get it started, depending upon the weather. And everyone will write their name down on a piece of paper, put the paper in a hat, pass the hat around, and everyone will look at the name. Now, if it was the same name that they had last year, we have to do it all over again. So you got that. You got all the names in the hat. You pull a name. You can't pull the same name twice. When you pull that name, that is your special Christmas person. They will post a list of a $50 item that they would like to have, at least three. And you get to pick one that you want to buy. All right? And then you might say, well, what about the other family members? What do you get for them? They get to post a stocking stuffer list. And they send it to everyone. And you get to pick out two, three, four, or five items to put in their stocking. Because that is a cost saver, so you're not buying presents for everybody all over the place. Because economics of Christmas is important. So that's been working quite well and a great money saver. So if you want to do something different this Christmas, put the names in the hat, pull a name. Everyone gets a different name. Everyone gets to pick out a gift for those three items for that person to submit. The other people will submit their stocking stuffer on the Fabulous. You can't go wrong with this thing here. And then you have a choice to pick out gifts to give to everyone, and it's not a burden. So Monrovia and beyond, enjoy your Christmas holiday, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in 2021, which I'm sure will be filled with surprises. Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, and any other holiday I have forgot, enjoy. Thank you.
Merry Christmas from the city of Monrovia. My name is Dylan Feik. I'm a city manager here for the city. I want to give a special thanks to Community Media the Foothills and KGEM for allowing me to share a few of my family's holiday traditions. First, I'd like to wish everyone a happy and healthy holiday season. 2020 has been a little bit different, and for many of us, it's not the joyful, typical time we have. It's been an incredibly challenging year for many of us, and I want to just wish the very best for all Monrovians, far and wide. And again, I thank you for allowing me to share a few traditions which tend to bring joy and happiness to my family, and I'd like to share some of those with you, hopefully lightening the holiday spirit and just sharing more about my family. In the Feik family, my wife Kira and I have been married for a number of years. And before we began having children, we started collecting ornaments at the places we traveled together. We didn't even have a Christmas tree. In fact, one of our very first Christmases I can remember, we actually organized our presents on a bookshelf that we had because we were too poor to have a tree. And so we kind of stacked everything up, making it look like a tree. They're wonderful memories and bring a tear to my eye because it reminds me of a time long ago before children when it was just my significant other and I. But now as we've grown our family, we have three children, we've also grown our ornament collection. We've been able to decorate our tree with relics that we've collected over the years, traveling, my wife and I, but also traveling with the kids. And I'd like to share just a few of those travel items with you. Of course, no Christmas tree in our family could be complete without baby's first Christmas ornaments. This was given to us by a dear friend who passed away from cancer a number of years ago. And so each year when we open this, we think of her, we think of the contribution she made to the world, to our family. And it's a great way for us to remember her, but particularly remember that very first Christmas with our first son. There was the time where I worked in the city of Knoxville, Iowa. Knoxville, if you don't know, is home to the sprint car Knoxville is known as the sprint car capital of the world. The National Sprint Car Hall of Fame and Museum is there. The Knoxville Raceway is there. It is the mecca for anybody who drives a sprint car. And so I really enjoyed my time there as an assistant city manager working on various projects. But this is where we first lived with our first son. And it was just a wonderful time in my life. Got to enjoy first Christmas there in Knoxville, Iowa. Living in the Midwest, we got to travel around a lot. The next couple ornaments are from places we traveled. The first one, if anybody knows what this is, it's called the Survivor Tree. And if you know what the Survivor Tree is, a number of years ago, following the Oklahoma City bombing in Oklahoma City, there was a tree outside one of the federal buildings. And the tree had been damaged and burned, about half of the tree. And the remainder of the tree, the federal government took it upon itself to try and preserve and protect that tree. It's just kind of a symbol of, I'll call it, Monrovia strong, Oklahoma City strong, long before the term was coined in the Boston bomb a number of years later. But the Survivor Tree was a symbol, an early symbol of resilience that, if you get a chance to ever go see that tree, it will bring you to your knees and just humility for what people went through that early terrorism attack here on our soil. A little bit more lighthearted, the National Mississippi River Museum and Aquarium, which is located in Dubuque, Iowa. Again, living in Iowa, we traveled around and got to go to the aquarium and learn about the different fish, wildlife, and forestry around the Mississippi River. We got to see bald eagles fishing above the river. We got to see how the levees worked and even some interesting trams that move people up and down the bluffs right in and around Dubuque, Iowa. One of my favorite memories, a couple years ago, we decided to track down a car that my parents owned back when I was a little kid. And we were very fortunate to get to meet the owner who decided it was better that the car return home to the Feik family. And so the very first classic car that I can remember falling in love with, I was able to purchase 20 some years later, a car that my parents previously owned, and now it belongs in my garage. It's called a 1968 California Special. And Hallmark actually came out with a California Special ornament the same year that we purchased the car. And so, of course, This is the most expensive ornament in the collection. They took advantage of us, but we were very happy to have this one. Where each year when we open this one, we remember that time that we tracked down that car along with my parents. And then lastly, one of my favorites, years ago, my wife and I lived in Alexandria, Virginia. I was, you know, very young. This is before I started a career as a city manager, and I was working as an intern in downtown Washington, D.C. I got to ride my bike into work every day, 8 miles each way, and I got to work at a nonprofit organization. I'm also, you know, to me, I got to explore the kind of that federal government center of our country, which included seeing sites like Mount Vernon. And so, you know, following along the Potomac and getting a chance to see where George Washington lived and how his you know, property has been maintained over the years, to me, it always feels Christmassy. So whenever I think of Mount Vernon, I think of Christmas time. So those are a few of the ornaments. We have several dozens more of the different places that we've traveled. Again, happy holidays from my family to yours. Certainly wish you and all Monrovias the very best. Have a Merry Christmas.
It's Dani
and Drew,
and we hope you're feeling at least a little bit Christmassy. There were no ornaments on the tree, just a faint jingle of bells ringing. Well, I can't deny Santa's right, even I must agree, a joyful noise keeps tapping at my feet. Getting in the spirit, starting to believe, getting in the spirit, feeling Christmassy. Well, I can't deny Santa's right, even I must agree, oh, the spirit's got a hold over me. The smell of pumpkin pie I lemon, tasty secrets baking from home to home. As the years fly by, Granny's right, even Scrooge would agree, fuzzy feelings always get the best of me. Getting in the spirit, starting to believe, getting in the spirit, feeling Christmassy. As the years fly by, Mama's right, I got the recipe, and the season's finally warming up to me.
Monrovia, I'm Jennifer Anderson, newly elected Monrovia School Board member, wishing you a warm and joyous holiday season. Now this year's been harder for all of us, so we're trying to find little ways to celebrate throughout the season. Normally we get together each December with family and friends to have one large baking day, and we make our favorite treats to share with our loved ones. This year we're doing a smaller thing just with our family each weekend, and we started off this season by baking my great-grandmother's Scandinavian cardamom bread. My great-grandmother died at over 100 years old, and this recipe has been in the family longer than that. We make it each year as a way to kick off our holiday season, and nothing says love and friendship more than sharing this out with others. Another of our favorite family traditions is to gather with our dearest friends to make homemade pasta and bolognese sauce. As the bolognese cooks, we roll out the pasta into longer and longer strands, frantically looking for enough towels and counter space for the pasta to dry before we can eat it. We feed 13 people that night, so there's an awful lot of pasta, and it takes a lot of work, but it's a whole lot of fun. This is a memory that we will miss this year. but we will cherish it, and next year we will be even more glad to join with our friends. As we close out 2020, I hope that you are all finding things to celebrate. With warm wishes from the Anderson family, that you all remain happy, healthy, and filled with the holiday spirit.
Welcome to the Palomares home. Today we're going to be sharing with you one of our favorite holidays recipes. It's very easy and delicious. The strawberry pretzel salad only requires 7 ingredients. You're going to need 6 ounces of strawberry jello, 2 cups of boiling water, 4 cups of frozen strawberry, 2 cups of pretzels, 3 tablespoons of sugar, 8 ounces of whipped topping, 8 ounces of cream cheese, 3/4 of a cup of melted butter, 1 cup of sugar. This is a 3-layer salad. The first one is going to be the pretzel with the butter and sugar. And then we're going to have the cream cheese with the whipped cream and the sugar. And the last one is going to be the jello and the strawberries. We're going to start off putting the 2 cups of pretzel on a food processor. 3 tablespoons of sugar and 3/4 of a cup of melted butter. So you can do it 15 seconds to 30. It depends how fine you want the pretzel to be. So my family likes with bigger pieces, so we don't crush it too long. We're gonna need a glass pan, 9 by 13. You can use butter or just spray it. I like to use more than 2 cups of pretzel, but it's up to your taste. So now we're gonna bake it for 8 to 10 minutes at 400 degrees. For the second layer, we're gonna mix 8 ounces of cream cheese with 1 cup of sugar. After you mix the cream cheese and sugar, we're gonna fold the cool whip. So once the pretzel cools down, we're gonna put our second layer. For our last layer, we're gonna mix 2 cups of hot water with the jello. And then we're gonna put the frozen sweetened strawberry. For the last layer, after we mix the strawberry and jello, we're gonna pour it on top of the second layer. Now we're gonna put in the refrigerator for the jello to set. When I told my co-workers that I was gonna make a strawberry pretzel salad, they all made funny faces. So I'm gonna take this to work and I'm gonna have them try it.
I'm gonna be trying the strawberry pretzel salad today and we'll see how this goes.
Mmm. Smells real fruity. I don't see no ranch.
I guess we're gonna be trying out this Christmas crack 2.0 today. Yeah.
He kind of hinted at it like on Thursday, and then I came in on Thursday and it wasn't here, and then like, you know.
You got upset.
You know, it was supposed to be here.
So I was working in the studio earlier today doing my shoot and they gave me this.
So I just came by to help and they handed me this, so I'm gonna try it. I really have no idea what's in it, but I'm told it's a salad and there's no lettuce and no croutons, so we'll see what happens.
I've had chicken feet.
Wow, it looks good. Look at all these different layers in here.
We finally have Christmas crack.
I've had raw octopus.
So I was working on some very important holiday stuff for the studio here, and they offered me free stuff.
But I don't know what this is.
Get some. Here we go.
really good. I feel like it's not a salad, but it's better than a salad, so there we go.
Really sweet. Mm.
This is fantastic.
It's actually really good.
That's pretty good. Not bad at all.
It's pretty good. It's like salty from the pretzels. It's pretty good with the jello.
This jello on top is really strong and full of flavor. I like it. So yeah, I guess I'll rate it give it a 10.
Get yourself one.
Mmm, love it.
I hope you enjoyed this very easy holiday treat. And from my family to yours, happy holidays.
You know, I have a tradition, and this is, it seems kind of silly. That's why I didn't even want to mention it. It was where, I discovered that at the Santa Anita Fashion Mall, but of course, a lot of malls, this is the way it is. The Christmas energy and the fervor of the shopping and everything gets more and more and more as you get to Christmas. But for some reason on Christmas Eve, it's anticlimactic. It's just don't go on the 24th because it's already kind of going down. It peaks at like the 21st or 22nd, maybe the 23rd, but like the 21st. Is, and especially it, whatever day lands like on a Saturday night, then go to a mall in the evening. And I did this last year. It was on a Saturday night. I think it was the 21st or 22nd. And man, there was just this, the energy's at the peak and you're just walking around and you're watching everybody just running around. They're all like, you know, it's just, I don't know. I just enjoy it. So just enjoy everyone else's energy. So that's my little tradition. So there we go. Anyway, I gotta get in, this is getting cold. Whew. I don't know why my cameraman Chris told me to get out here. I don't think he likes me. Maybe because, oh, and the other cameraman, Jalen. Oh, well, that guy's they're both like, yeah, let's get him to stand out in the snow. Oh, and they got these big parkas on with the little fuzzy thing around their little face, they're little Eskimos. You know, and anyway, so all right, I want you guys to have a great Christmas, and I'll talk to you guys later. Happy New Year.
Hello, I'm Connie Mustang. I'm one of the producers of KGEM, and I just wanted to wish everyone a happy holidays, and I hope you have a safe and prosperous New Year. And one of the ways that I thought I would share that is by sharing what one of my favorite things is about the holidays. You can get creative and still enjoy. What is my favorite thing? Friends and family.
Hello.
Hi.
Yeah, so Lima and I are here because we just want to share some ideas that some of our other friends that are around us gave us for how to have fun with friends and family during the holidays of a pandemic. Mm-hmm. Okay, so some of the ideas we got is Frances over here to the right. She is a computer whiz, so she wanted to share that she does FaceTime and she does emails and she likes to use her computer or her telephone to send special messages to friends.
That's smart! Good girl!
Right. And then behind us, over to my other side, we have Della way in back.
Ooh, hey Della!
And we've got Benji in front.
Hi, Benj!
And down here in Benji's arms is Don Carlioki.
Hi, Don Carlioki.
Yeah, so these are some of our friends. And up on the tree, we see Pops.
Hey, Pops!
So these are all our friends. And so we're going to share some of their ideas, like Francis's. Pops' idea was to make cookies.
I love cookies!
Right, everybody loves cookies. Well, almost everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
So cookies are good.
Cookies are very good.
Then we have Benji. He celebrates Hanukkah, so he likes to write letters.
He writes letters?
Yeah, because Hanukkah is 8 days of celebration. So he makes 8 letters that he gives out as gifts. So let's say he was going to share Hanukkah with you. He would send you 1 envelope every day that has a different letter to say how much he values you as a friend.
That's wonderful. Good job, Benji!
And Della in back, she likes arts and crafts.
Me too!
And so she's going to make some friends.
She's gonna make friends?
Well, yeah, she's gonna make some new friends. And you and I are gonna make some new friends this holiday too. However you celebrate your holiday, I'm hoping that you will feel the love of friends and family near and far, however way you do it. We hope that you have a safe and happy holiday, and that the new year finds you prosperous, and also that it is a better year for us that's coming in. And hopefully we'll be able to see you again.
San Victoria's of the Monrovia Police Department. In terms of Christmas traditions, I was starting off here with here at work because there have been numerous years where I worked either Christmas Eve or Christmas Day or Christmas night. And a tradition that we always did throughout those years and still do today is the entire shift, including our dispatchers and our records personnel, we would always do a big potluck. Everybody would bring in their favorite dish and we'd have a big feast in between calls while here at work. On a more personal level, I think a big Christmas tradition that me and my girls always have is that since they were in strollers, every year there is a local outdoor mall that would put up a big Christmas tree and have a Christmas lighting. So my girls and I would, even since they were in strollers, I'd push them down there and we'd all take a picture in front of the Christmas tree so we could give it to mom on Christmas morning. And that's what we like to do. And that's what makes Christmas special for us. I know everybody has their own traditions and their own little things they like to do as families or as individuals. And I think it's we keep that spirit up, especially during this holiday season that we have here today in this year. It just makes things that much more easier on all of us. Thank you.
All right. I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you. Decorations of red
on a green Christmas tree won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me. And when those blue snowflakes start falling, that's when those blue memories start calling. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white, but I'll have a blue, 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 blue Christmas. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white, but I'll have a blue, 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 blue Christmas.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You've been fantastic. I'd like to give a shout out to my amazing, this guy right here. Get this guy. Please, yeah, look at this. This guy right here is fantastic, amazing. Our guy behind the camera right now, Jarrett, he also has done the amazing, fantastic sound engineering you hear. And our Lord and Savior, Chris Luton, thank you for everything that you do. Literally, we love you. We couldn't do anything without you.
One of my favorite things for the holiday is this calendar. These calendars are a tradition that were originally created by my sister Missy. The Palomares family lives all over the world. So having everybody represented in a calendar on Christmas morning is one of the nicest gifts you can get. It's a reminder to all of us that family is one of the most important and cherished things we have in this world. This is a lot of work for my nieces, for my sister, and I'm very grateful that they take the time to do this, because this is a special memory that I will keep forever, and it's one that maybe will give you an idea to do for your family. Happy holidays, everyone.